Hello guys, welcome to the video where we're going to discuss order types in MT5. Now I've decided to create a separate video about this subject simply because in MT5 we have been introduced to these two types of orders that we can see. I'm not going to bore you with all this. This is basically taken from the MKO5 website. You can find all that information in the help file as well, so you can go ahead and read it. But what we're going to do here is go ahead and explain the differences between these orders. So the four type of orders that we have previously, as we know them from MT4, didn't change, right? So let's go ahead and cover them very quickly. By limit is basically type of order where the current price is moving right here. We want to see the price giving us a pullback, a move down, okay, to go to lower levels, and this is where the actual order is going to be executed. This is where we're going to enter a buy trade, right? This is what the buy limit order is. Buy stop, on the other hand, is very useful when it comes to breakouts. Let's say you have a range, okay, current price is here, and you're looking for a breakout above this range right here, which means if the price crosses this level, I would like to go ahead and buy exactly there on this level. And this is where buy stop order comes in play. Okay, then we have sell limit and sell stop. Pretty similar situation, just vice versa. Again, we have the price moving here. Okay, we want to go ahead and trade the pullback. We're currently in a sell, in a bearish momentum. We're looking for deeper pullbacks, and this is where the sell limit comes in play. If the price, the current price, moves a bit higher, it reaches the zone that we want to see reached, this is where the sell is going to be executed, and our expectation is that the price will continue then lower. On the other hand, we have the sell stop, where we can give again the example of the range. We're looking for a breakout below this zone, which means we're going to put a sell stop order right here. And if the current market price drops below the level we have specified, we're going to execute a sell order right here. In other words, what we can conclude here is that those four types of orders have one condition only: the price to move up or down, and this is where we're going to execute either the buy or the sell. Okay, so far so good. I believe this is simple, okay, and you probably already know these kind of things. Now, the more interesting part comes with the new orders which were introduced to us, namely the buy stop limit and the sell stop limit. Now, in very simple terms, we can think about these two orders as two condition order, okay? We need to see two things happening before the order is actually executed. So when it comes to buy stop limit, for example, imagine this is the current price right here. And what we are telling the MT4 platform to do is, first of all, wait for the price to go and reach that level, okay, condition number one. Then let the price move lower a bit, reach that zone, and only here I want you to execute my buy trade. Now, on the other hand, we have the sell stop limit, which is doing a very similar thing, just in the opposite direction. This is where the current market price is moving, and we're telling the MT4 platform to do the following. Let the price reach that zone, first of all, this level right here. Then, if it provides a pullback to the upside, this is where I would like to see my sell order being executed. So why is this useful? Very simple. Let's say again, let's give the example with the range. You're moving in a range, and the most classical probably idea of trading the ranges when it comes to breakouts is this. So you have a resistance, you're waiting for the price to break, and then you're looking for this pullback to retest the breakout, and this is where you want to execute the trade. So let's say it's in the evening, you identify the range, and you know that you're expecting some moves during the night. This is where the buy stop limit order comes in play. So this is where you say, okay, let's first of all have a breakout, let the price reach this level, okay, with the breakout, and then I would like to go ahead and trade the pullback, which is basically going to give you the ability to do so by using the buy stop limit order, and that is where your buy order will be executed. Same story is happening with the sell. Let's say you have a range of some sort, or you're waiting for a low to be broken. This is where you can say, okay, let the price break below this low, let it move downwards, then I would like to see the pullback towards this zone right here, and this is where I want my sell order to be executed. Okay, in the beginning when I was reading the way they explained it, it doesn't really become very clear, okay, but once you apply it to the chart and you start using it, it's actually pretty obvious and pretty helpful. I have also provided here a screenshot, okay, of how to actually fill the order and the details. So let's say we're talking about buy stop limit. Those are the two conditions, as we said previously, that we must fill in. The first one is the price, okay? So basically what that means is, if the price reaches 147.48, and currently this is our price, right? The bid and ask. So what I'm telling here, the MT5 platform, is if the price goes ahead and reaches that level, then wait for a pullback, okay, set my buy order at that price. So what I'm expecting to see is push reaching 147.48, then wait for a pullback, and if the price comes to this zone, okay, the stop limit price, then this is where I would like to see the buy order being executed. Okay, another example for the stop limit order, again similar situation. This is where the current price is, okay, and what we are telling the platform is, if the price reaches 147.31, which is right here, then wait for a pullback towards 147.50, okay, and only then execute my sell order. So the two fields that we need to focus on when setting this kind of orders is the price, which is condition number one, and the stop limit price, which is condition number two. Of course, stop losses, take profit, this is all self-explanatory, along with the volume right here. So that would be all for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it's now clear how these two new orders introduced to us work, and I'll see you in the next video.